在台菲关系达到最紧张，台湾的代表团希望到菲律宾讨一个公道，无功而返的时候，许多人在问为什么？为什么我们的外交这么弱？为什么我们的渔民可以在海上被一个像土匪一样的国家践踏？更多人想问一个问题：我们的好朋友美国，长期是台湾非常重要的外交盟友，在这一次这件事情里头，为什么如此不公正？我们今天文前世界周报将为大家来回顾美国在南海争议里头的角色，以及所谓的南海主权争议发展的历史。它从当时明成祖郑和下西洋，到二次世界大战，一直到后来的中越海战，一直到最近的南海主权，就是一连串的历史发展过程。只是台湾一直都认为这只是美国重返亚太战略，美国和中国大陆，或是中国大陆和越南，中国大陆和菲律宾的冲突。一直等到这一次我们的渔民遭遇到菲律宾如土匪般的屠杀之后，我们才开始意识到在南海的主权争议里头，台湾是如此的孤单。我们来看一下在美国的记者会现场，美国现在虽然有国会议员站出来对这件事情表达遗憾，对菲律宾提出批评，但是这些国会议员本来就是台湾海外侨民友好，也就是在当地跟台湾的游说团体有关系非常深的国会议员。而美国的官方国务院的发言人，他的记者召会里头的定调几乎是两岸，包括连美国的记者在现场都明显的感觉到他的偏袒。我们待会儿会给大家看这整场记者会里头他几个非常重要的外交辞令。各位观众朋友，外交辞令你听起来可能乍看之下不了解是什么，我们帮大家做出分析。
命出去没命回来，
哎，我们听的心都碎掉了。
难道这就是讨海人的悲哀吗？命丧菲律宾公务员枪下的洪石臣，遗孀哭到肝肠寸断，这样的场面令人鼻酸，更让人愤慨。杀人者岂能让他逍遥法外？
这是杀人啊！
对，
这是违法杀人啊！
台湾屏东琉球级渔船“广大星”28号，5月9号在北纬20度、东经123度、鹅銮鼻东南东170里台菲重叠海域处捕捞黑尾鱼。没想到却遭到了菲律宾公务船冷血扫射，弹痕累累的船身一共有59个弹孔，并且集中在驾驶座、引擎室跟油箱，而这些都是船员遇袭时的藏身之处，可见得菲律宾人下手有多凶残。尽管台湾在12号发出了72小时的最后通牒，要求菲律宾逞凶道歉赔偿，但13号适逢菲律宾的其中选举，总统艾奎诺三世对台湾的要求几乎置之不理。
It is in the interest of both parties to proceed on a calm basis. So that we are proceeding. And I of course, course it through the DFA, no? As the Secretary of Foreign Affairs to monitor, but the lead person has to be Mako because of the One China policy.
公务员无情残杀一名台湾渔民，菲律宾总统艾奎诺三世却表现得蛮不在乎，甚至还发出让人齿冷的微笑。
There was a death, no?
The United States has been in touch with both the Philippine government and the Taiwan authorities regarding this incident, and we welcome the Philippine government's pledge to conduct a full and transparent investigation into the incident.
美国方面在回应这起令人发指的海上喋血案时，不但没有对菲律宾提出严厉谴责，立场更明显倾斜。
Who take the provocative action first? The result is Philippine firing at the boat. So do you think to using the bullet or firing on the boat is the right way here to solve the problem? You are calling for this South China Sea conduct. Do you agree the brutal way to solve the problem?
We encourage both sides to refrain from provocative actions. I don't think I have anything further to parse in this case.
What is the alleged provocation on the Taiwanese side in this case? I don't, you know, one side shot the other side, right? So if I shoot you, would you want the government to warn both of us?
I hope you don't.
Shoot each other? When you are warning both sides, you're giving equivalency. What is the Taiwanese action that you're concerned about?
Well, again, the Philippine government is looking into this case. I don't want to get ahead of their process of investigating what happened.
Firing of firearms against unarmed civilians.
Again, I'm not going to speculate on this specific case. I appreciate all of the questions on it.
萨奇的回答不止两岸媒体，就连美国记者也明显听出了美方偏颇的立场。当焦点回到枪击发生海域在哪儿，美方的答复更充满了护航意味。
It appears the incident took place in or near disputed waters where the Philippines and Taiwan both claim fishing rights. The United States does not take a position on the proper location of a maritime boundary in that area.
Near disputed area, so it's disputed whether it's in disputed area or not?
I mean, again, that's a pretty rough estimate.
Can't you just say it's in disputed area then?
Again, this is in or near disputed waters. That's all the accuracy we, that's all the level of detail
I mean,
we have about.
Everywhere in the world, correct? Everywhere in water, it must be in or at some point near to disputed waters.
The point is, the point is, Brad, we're not able to pinpoint exactly whether it was inside of the disputed waters
it was or, in the water.
Or very nearby that disputed area.
The death of the Taiwanese fishermen was a main factor why there has been outrage all over Taiwan. The United States has expressed regret over the death of the fishermen. Would the United States express something more than regret, sympathy, or because after all, Taiwan is an ally of the United States, as you say.
It is up to the Philippines and Taiwan to determine the specific terms of the resolution on this immediate issue.
根据广大星二十八号的航行记录来看，事发当时渔船并没有越界，美国方面却坚称枪击发生在争议海域。而事发一周之后，菲律宾调查局报告出炉，指控台湾渔船企图冲撞公务船，是不折不扣的 bad guy 坏人，又在两岸关系上玩弄一中原则。大陆学者分析，菲律宾就是靠着老美撑腰才敢有恃无恐。
现在南海局势异常的复杂，那么相关国家在南海问题，包括美国战略重返之后，使整个南海局势异常的复杂。那么菲律宾呢，一贯的风格之后呢，又来了一个美国在背后撑腰的这样一种感觉，给他一个错觉，以为他今天可以像过去那一样，就是排除过去那种相对克制的姿态，我行我素。于是乎呢，就导致目前这个局面，就是本来一个很简单的一个事情，就是你明显的犯了错误。那么你就尽快的调查，给台湾一个答复，还有一个准确答复，这样我觉得它就是一个不负责任的一个国家的一个表现。
美国跟菲律宾近年来多次就加强军事同盟关系频频互访，并且发表共同声明。菲律宾的苏比克湾跟克拉克空军基地更为美国重返亚太中心提供了据点。这也难怪，一方是手无寸铁的朴实渔民，一方是犹如海盗持枪扫射的菲律宾公仆。高喊和平解决争端的美国，这次却袒护暴力相向的菲律宾。说穿了，要为死去的洪石臣讨回公道，台湾人更应该看清美国含糊其辞背后的政治利益。